Hello and welcome back to my channel. Our today's topic of learning is Rural Marketing Research Process. Myself, Professor Kinjal Thakur, and let's get started. Rural research is the guidepost of laying the foundation of the successful marketing program. Marketing research is essentially to any strategic and operational decision making, as the rural market is relatively new compared to its urban counterparts. There is a crying need to understand rural India, its belief and practices. There are many challenges to designing and conducting rural marketing research. There is lack of real-time information and data on rural markets. Illiterate and semi-literate rural people cannot easily comprehend the written words, and lack of exposure to many concepts and practices of urban India also make their visual depiction incomparable. Further, there are not many appropriate marketing research tools to map rural consumer behavior. Western ranking and rating tools often hold little relevance for a rural respondent as a framework of evaluation. Rural India is also highly scattered, remote, and inaccessible, making data collection difficult. Rural research therefore needs to be seen from a different perspective. Rural marketing research process. The need for any marketing research arises on account of gaps in existing information based on which the problem is designed. The research leads to insight and a solution for that problem. Between these two stages of defining the problem and arriving at a solution, there are a number of steps that should be completed by the marketing research process, which are displayed on your screen. First is defining the business research objective. Step 2, determining the research budget. Step 3, designing the research. Step 4, sampling method and size, designing research instrument, field work, data collection and analysis, reporting the finding for decision making. We will understand each steps in detail in the further video. Step number 1, defining the objective. Defining the objective is the first step in the marketing research process and involves two tasks: defining business objectives and defining the research objectives. Business objectives. Business objectives state the purpose for which the organization conducting research will use the finding of the data. Normally, it is stated in terms of the tangible benefit. For example, to design a new product catering to rural consumer, or to design a new distribution channel for a specific product for a rural markets in India. Research objectives. Research objective states the expected research output, which helps in taking decision to achieve business objectives. Framing the research objectives call for a clear understanding of the kind of the information required to facilitate the decision-making process. For example, to map the buying behavior of rural consumer for a tractor, or to identify and profile the segment existing among the rural consumer mass. Step number 2, determining the research budget. Most marketing research projects involve a certain amount of cost incurred for the collecting information and analyzing the data. Budget decision depends on the research approach to be used for a particular study. Taking the budget decision involves two major steps, that is, specifying the approximate value of the information to be collected and determining the maximum amount that can be spent on the study. Once the budget is finalized, the research can be designed accordingly. Step number 3, designing the research. The third stage of making marketing research involves developing an effective designing and gathering the required information, which includes a decision on the research approach. Research approaches are designed on the basis of the purpose, nature, and source of data. Using these three criteria, research can be classified as purpose, exploratory, descriptive, and causal. Exploratory means exploring into a completely new horizon, which, as the name suggests. Descriptive, again, as the name suggests, describing its feature. And causal means understanding the cause and effect of a variable. Nature of data, qualitative and quantitative. Qualitative quantitative research is number driven and involves the use of structured interviews, questionnaires, or other tools for data collection. On the other hand, qualitative research doesn't involve any fixed format or set of questions to be answered by the respondent. Instead, the emphasis is on free-flowing interview or discussion to aid an in-depth exploration of the various issues or problems. Next is source of data, that is primary and secondary. Primary research involves collecting fresh data for a specific research purpose through the methods, and secondary research is based on the data that is to be collected in the past, been published, and existing in some repository. Step number four, that is sampling design. Once the research design has been developed, the next step of marketing research is sampling design, which involves designing the sampling method and sampling size. There are various sampling methods, such as simple random sampling, systematic random sampling, stratified sampling, purposive sampling, snowball sampling, multi-stage sampling, etc. But the researcher has to choose the method which is appropriate or the data which they are going to collect. If they are going to collect the quantitative data, they have to select the sampling method accordingly. And if they are going to collect the qualitative data, they have to select the methods accordingly. It completely depends on the source of data or the type of data they are going to collect. Next one is sampling size. In rural, qualitative research, sample size is important only to obtain the complete information about the issues taken up for the research. The size depends on the number of segmenting being studied, and the representation of each segment should be included. For example, while determining the sample size for a product usage, study a representation from user, aware but non-user, and dropout user should also be taken. Also, while in the field, the researcher can stop collecting data once information redundancy is achieved. That is, till they are saturated with the information and start receiving repetitive responses. Thus, sample size determination in rural qualitative research is not static but dynamic, and is more matter of judgment on the part of the researcher as per the situation in the actual field. Step number five, that is designing the research instrument. The research instrument can be of three types, that is questionnaire, survey, and observation. Questionnaire. Questionnaire means a set of questions which are to be answered by the respondent. Survey. Survey means examining and recording its features. Observation. Observation means observing deeply to the attributes of the population. But according to my suggestion, questionnaire would not fit into rural marketing research process, as people into the rural area are illiterate or semi-literate people. They are not going to answer, or they are not understanding the bulky questions which are framed into the questionnaire. So survey and observation would be a good designing instrument for the rural marketing research. Step number six, organizing the field and collecting the data. Organizing the field, choosing the proper people who could answer the question, or choosing an appropriate village where you could collect a good amount of data is very important, and collecting the proper data from the proper individual. Once the instrument is designed, then you need to record, or then you need to collect the data from them. So choosing the right people, getting trust from that people, and then collecting the data is very important into the rural marketing. People are not friendly as the urban peoples are while giving the answers. So first you need to get the confidence from them that you are a trustworthy person, and then you could collect data from the rural people. This is the biggest challenge for the researcher, to collect data from the rural people, because they are not trusting while answering the research work or research questions. Next step is data collection and analysis. Analysis part is very important to any research point, right? In the case of quality research, the data collected is in the form of notes, audio recordings, and PRA charts. Is transcribed and then collected in a set format. Further, content analysis is done using filters and specific color codes to find similarities and variations in the data. In quantitative research, data input frames are prepared in Excel or SPSS software, where the data captured is the questionnaires is transformed for analysis. Broadly, three types of quantitative analysis can be done on the number of variables involved: univariant, bivariant, and multivariant. Step number 8, that is reporting the findings. As the last step in the marketing research process, the researcher presents the finding relevant to the marketing decision to the rural marketer. The report of the finding is prepared around the research objective of the study. The following are the points which are covered into the marketing research process. That is executive summary, which provides the snapshot and key highlights of the research findings. Objectives provides the business and research objectives. Research methodology, which describes the methodology used to conduct the research study. Findings provide the detailed finding for the research. Conclusion, recommendation, and annexure or appendix. Conclusion and recommendation sum up the findings and provides the way for the what, and annexure provides the important additional and detailed information used in the analysis. These are the basic 8 step which is used in the rural marketing research process. It is an ideal steps which could be used by any researcher or any organization for any business or research objectives. But there could be a minimization or extension of many steps. Some steps could be lengthier into some research, and some steps could be cut out into the research. It depends on the topic, it depends on the researcher, and it depends on the organization and the budget. So, thank you and have a good day.